They say we don't do enough. We don't stock enough skates, especially the bargain basement variety. We don't carry in lines or know the best place to get them. We don't have every package from every manufacturer. They say all these things. Yet every day, we measure your feet. We study your stance and tailor your fit. We mount your plates and answer your questions. We build skates that make you fly. We're not here for them. We're here for you. And we want to make you go really, really fast. Make them catch up. Visit us online at fastgirlskates.com.
When you don't buy Antic skate boots, you buy some other brand. When you buy some other brand, you suck at practice. When you suck at practice, you're unprepared for Team Antic USA skater Carmen Getsum. When you're unprepared for Carmen Getsum, she destroys you on the track. When she destroys you on the track, you end up on the trainer's table with a concussion and major injuries. Don't end up with a concussion and major injuries. Buy Antic skate boots.
This was definitely a proud moment for me, wearing the black, white, and red. It's such a bold uniform, first of all. It's just Texas right across. That's a team you skate out onto that track, and there's just no guessing who you are. You just feel the team. It feels very much like the kind of thing you want to wear out into battle, and it's really great. I like it. I'm Fifi Nominon with the Texas Roller Girls Texecutioners, and S1 is part of my uniform.
International 2014 WFTDA Division I playoffs in Evansville continue, and it has been a quirky day, let me tell you. I'm Danny Mack alongside Electra Blue. It was a lot of weird things happening. We're at this point in the series where we can kind of look back and say, yeah, you know what? A lot of things happened where it was like, okay, that's expected. A lot of the top seeds won. Moving on, including number two, Texas, and number three, Windy City, that we will see later on. But some of the weirder things kind of happened as well, Electra Blue.
Well, it all started at 10 a.m. with the Steel City, Ohio game. Ohio fouling out three players that game and failing to field a jammer in the first half. Of course, Steel City taking a 39-point jam, which they never recovered from. Unfortunately, Ohio leaving with 187 on that. Steel City taking it with 206. And I think this is the quirkiest one today. I don't know if actually some of you out there haven't had an explanation. So Houston versus Toronto. So second half, we have DBC going to the penalty box. It was going in for her sixth penalty. She goes into the penalty box hot, gets expelled. So watch it. Being the captain, has to take her legal procedure penalty. Watch it goes to sit in the box, which would have been her sixth penalty. Gets up from the penalty box, takes off the pivot cover to bring it back to the bench, getting another illegal procedure penalty.
Whoops.
Herself fouling out.
Yeah.
So that was pretty weird.
Yeah. As we continue, yes.
I forgot to mention DBC came back to watch the bout. That's why she did get got the second illegal procedure penalty. So yes, very weird. Then 2 p.m. London versus Jacksonville. Jacksonville, number four seed. London, of course, number one seed. Jacksonville just totally running away with that game
right.
The very first half.
Yep.
And we just watched. Oh, no. We still have more. Oh, Nashville. Oh, I'm sorry. London, 232
That's right.
Jacksonville, 136. Then again, Nashville versus Steel City at 4 p.m.
Yeah, and that was Steel City. That was... again, a very physical bout, but the quirky things that happened in that one.
Oh, goodness gracious. I have forgotten the quirky thing. Nashville taking that for 214. Steel City, 151.
And that will continue us on here. We got probably a potentially quirky thing with Windy City and Texas. Windy City... and somebody noticed this actually on the Talk to WFTDA hashtag on Twitter. With Windy City has a five normally wears the 6-point star, you see, because of the flag, because of the Chicago flag. They're wearing a 5-point star. They'll be wearing that again tonight. That is because Texas has a white cap cover, the white helmet cover, with the red star on it. So Windy City doesn't want to wear the same thing. They're not going to be wearing the 6-pointer. They will be wearing a black star with a 5-point on it.
And another little tidbit of information. Bloody Mary, veteran skater for the Texas Roller Girls Texecutioners, recovering from ACL surgery. This is the very first playoffs in the history of roller derby playoffs that she has missed. And I just remembered, sorry, Steel City Quirks, not rocket science, with her magic tape that came from Papa and Mama Doc, who are here, of course, from Windy City, traveling medics with Windy City. So it's been a little bit of a weird day, for
sure. It has. It has. Lots of surprises. But, again, we're seeing sort of the typical, sort of what we expected. Right now, the marquee matchup, the 8 p.m. Central matchup here in the playoffs, number 2 Texas, number 3 Windy City, coming up, and with the play-by-play, AK 40 ounce.
I am AK 40 ounce. Doing play-by-play, though, will be Reverend Norb, and we are happy to be here.
We are pleased as punch, AK. Anyway, you are watching the International 2014 Women's Flat Track Derby Association Division I Playoffs live from interesting Evansville, Indiana, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and Demolition City Roller Derby.
We're fired up, if you couldn't tell. So, looking at the matchups, we have the number 2 versus number 3 seed. This one played out according to the brackets. Everything on paper came out with these two. Two big, big wins for these two teams. The number 2 seed Texas Roller Girls coming in, the 6th ranked team in the WFTDA. They will take on the Windy City Rollers. The 3rd seed ranked number 11 in the WFTDA. Interesting stat coming into this game. Historically, Windy City 5-1 against Texas. So dominating history by Windy City. Interesting to see how this one will pair out. And first off, why don't you give us Texas's line?
Interesting does not quite cover it. All right, wearing the Darth Vader black from Austin, Texas, it's the Texas Roller Girls Texecutioners. Number 02 is Shortcut. Number 03 is Olivia Shootin' John. 108 is Fifi Nomenon. Number 12 is Debella DeBall. Number 15 is Trauma. 1600 is Barbara Ambush. Number 19 is Molotov Impale. 22 is Polygon. 27 is Peace War. Number 5 is Smarty Pants. Number 55 is Hoss the Boss. Number 812 is Cease and Desist. Number 813 is Bitter Cup. And rounding out the roster for the Texecutioners of the Texas Roller Girls, it's number 989, Sarah Heipel, AK.
And wearing white and the 5-pointed star, the Windy City Rollers of Chicago, Illinois. Number 00, Tamikaze, 07, Jackie Daniels. 219, Who's Your Mama. 24, Sandrine Ranjon. Number 25, Varla Vendetta. 303, Kenichi Wow. Number 4, Jen Trainer. 52, Sargentina. Number 65, Ms. Dr. Joseph L. Simonis. Number 68, Moby Nibs. Number 75, Bork, Bork, Bork. Number 77, Ying O Fire. 81, Ruth Anasia. And 999, Yvette, your maker.
Your officials for this evening are head referee Corbin Russell. We've also got Werner Bomb Bombed. We've got Code Adam, Jean-Philippe Aman, a parking lot, Izzy Demented, Stabby McDude Bro, and Jules and Regulations. That rounds out our our officiating roster, but it would be fun if they announced.
Yes, it would be interesting. And that, again, does not cut it. So, folks, those are the players. The stage is set, and before you on your screen, you see in white the Windy City Rollers, number 3 in this tournament, and in black and red, Texas Roller Girls out of Austin, Texas, the 2 seed. The winner of this game will face the London Roller Girls tomorrow. The winner of this game also punches their ticket to the Nashville WFTDA 2014 Championship Weekend. The loser will face off against Jacksonville for the 3rd spot.
And the whistle blows. We are off slightly behind that fast girl skates Jammerlin and now struggling to get free. That's number 24 for the Windy City Rollers in the white. That is Sandrine Ranjon. She is paired up with number 03. That is Olivia Shootin' John in the black of Texas. Everyone attempting to get through a gobbed up, gunked up queue. And first lead jammer of the evening goes to the Windy City Rollers, courtesy of Sandrine Ranjon.
Ranjon coming into this tournament after a break from roller derby. A slow start yesterday, but a good start here in this game.
Both jammers free, and after a surgical 4-point strike, Ranjon calls off the jam. 4-0 early lead for Windy City. Just over half a minute elapsed in this first period. On the jammer line now for the Windy City Rollers in the white, wearing number 65 with the disorienting black star on the jammer panty. That is, shortened for announcing purposes, Josie.
Yes, Ms. Dr. Joseph L. Simonis.
And she is bear up with number 108. That is Fifi Nominon in the black of the Texas Roller Girls Executioners. Struggled to get through the outside of that pack for Josie. She's a really working left and right, but finds absolutely no yielding of that Texas wall. And there's what appears to be a rugby scrum breaking out at turn one, which eventually cycles Fifi Nominon back to the Fast Girl Skates jammer line. Everyone cycled back now, recycling in vogue. Fifi Nominon halted between turn one and two, breaks free. This is the first lead jammer done for Texas, courtesy of Fifi Nominon.
Fifi Nominon doing a lot more jamming this season. She's had much success with it, now coming on her scoring pass. Meanwhile, Josie approaching the back of the pack. Two quick points for Fifi Nominon. Interesting about Ms. Dr. Joseph L. Simonis, just moving up from second win, had a big season with them, and a highly anticipated addition to the Windy City Rollers All-Stars.
And starting off our third jam on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, that's number 25 in the white with the blue and red trim of the Windy City Rollers All-Stars. That is, of course, the veteran Varla Vendetta. She is going up against number 55, star of last year's championships. That is Hoss the Boss in the black of the Texecutioners. Hoss is dancing left and right. Body spilling out in free is Varla Vendetta, lead jammer, Windy City Rollers. The bit of debris on the infield, it does not appear to be anything game-threatening.
Varla Vendetta running right into the wall of Texas, waiting right out there. You got Shortcut along with Smarty Pants holding the back two wall, being braced out in front. Barbara Ambush now coming back to block.
Out and about on her scoring pass, that is Hoss the Boss, already embarked on a rather more of a scoring struggle than a pass. However, she does pick up 3 points. That's Varla Vendetta, but three unanswered points for Windy City. 7-2 is going to be our score. A little over 27 minutes to go in the first period.
Next jam will be a one-skater pack advantage for Texas. Bork, Bork, Bork for the first penalty getter, and has two so far in this game for Windy City. Jammers of record will be Yingo Fire, number 777, in the white of Windy City. She'll be opposed by 03 OJ Olivia Shootin' John.
I'm glad you could read those numbers, because I sure the heck can't. Anyway, this is the second jam for Olivia Shootin' John, and OJ tries to pummel her way through the outside. Yingo Fire tries to find the inside. The inside was open, but the problem is getting there. Yingo Fire struggling against a strong Texas blockade in the interior. Still spun outside. Lead jammer is, in fact, Ying of Fire. Two Texas blockers heading to the notorious RET penalty box. That's going to thin the pack and increase the odds for Ying of Fire.
Bitter Cup sitting along with Trauma. Trauma, recent transfer to Texas.
And we are going to see a 5-point pass. Grand slam for Ying of Fire. Windy City Rollers. 12-2 right now. 10-point lead.
Fist pump right there from Ying of Fire. It's nice to see Ying of Fire out there along with Varla Vendetta. Two long-time skaters. They've been around as long as Windy City's been around and still bringing it at such a high level, Norm.
And here's a skater that's been around for a while that's only been on Windy City recently. You might know her from playing on the Chicago Outfit, where she wore number 24. Now she is number 4. That is Jan Trainer, the jammer for the Windy City Rollers in the white. She is going up against number 108, Fifi Nominon for Texas. And Jan Trainer, oh, almost has the inside line. Winds up in a big collision with Sarah Heipel. That is going to cause an improper pass. She is out of the pack. She is not lead jammer. Lead jammer is now courtesy of Texas. And right away they call it off, wasting no time, preserving that 12-2 lead in favor of Windy City.
Quick call off right there by Fifi Nominon. Of course, very heady player out there. Sees the whole track, even when she's not looking. A great stand from Killbox, the former Killbox, Sarah Heipel. A lot of former players, former something players in this matchup. Sarah Heipel out there along with Barbara Ambush on that last defensive stand. This next one going to see Haas the Boss in the black for Texas up against Sandrine Ranjon.
Ranjon dances around Smarty Pants to the outside. She gets a very quick lead jammer for the Windy City Rollers.
And speaking of former players, you may remember Ranjon as the former Denver and Montreal player Francie Pants.
And we've got a track cut is being issued on the... That's being issued on Francie Pants. It is going to be a power jam for number 55, Hoss the Boss, for the Texas Roller Girls.
Texas down by 10 right now. Has to take advantage of the power jam, and Hoss there to do it. tiptoeing around in a circle and picking up 5 points.
I've seen a number of pirouettes this week, and that's the only triple pirouette I have seen thus far. Haas, the boss, now under scoring pass. Pack looked like it was going to yield a nice, big, juicy center in lanes 2 and 3. It does not. She's trying to take the inside. She cannot. Pack is windy bridging, so the pack maintains some bit of coherence. And Jan Trainer out of that notorious RED penalty box. Grand slam horror for Haas, the boss. Jan Trainer cycled over, getting scored upon.
Oh, big hit right there, taking down Ran John. Meanwhile, Haas, the boss, bossing up against that wall. She is one of those skaters as a jammer who can be left to her own devices to fight the wall and push it, doing such a good job already early in this game, Norm.
Beg your pardon for addressing Sandrine Ranjon as Jan Trainer. Going to take a while to remember what Trainer's new number is. Looks like for a second time, Bork heading to the notorious RED penalty box.
This will be her third penalty. Had two in the last one. It's already in early penalty trouble for one of the most important blockers.
And Haas, the boss, gets another grand slam, enters on another scoring pass. She is obviously expending a lot of energy getting through this pack, and heck, who wouldn't? I don't think that that is a unique condition to a jammer on either team, nor will it be for the duration of this festive roller derby Donnybrook.
One each going to the notorious RED penalty box. We've got Hoosier Mama for Windy City, along with number 15, Trauma, second trip to the box. Grand slam goes up for Texas. And 4 points being answered back by Windy City.
And it looks like we've got a lead change. Texas now in the lead to the tune of 22-16, 6-point lead, 22 and 3-quarter minutes to go in the first period.
I'd like to thank Adam Wheels. Train hard, play smart, skate Adam. Adam Wheels. Also want to send a shout out to our penalty box sponsor, Notorious Gear Deodorant. Smell clean even if you play dirty.
And
it would be a terrible product if it worked the opposite way.
I would imagine so. Back on the jammer line and now off of it. And lead jammer, that is number 108. That is Fifi Namanon for Texas in the black. She's going up against Josie. Josie for Windy now on her scoring pass, looking to truncate Fifi Namanon scoring at a single pass. Even a single pass is hard fought here. A lot of contact. That's going to draw a back block. AK power jam Windy City.
Fought too hard. Came in too hot. Did Fifi. Will take a seat in, as I said, the notorious RED penalty box. That leaves the rookie jammer, Joe Z, out there fighting against Heupel, as well as Barbara Ambush and Trauma. Trauma now up front. Barbara Ambush there with her. Joe Z not finding a lot of room, but there is going to get some space. Ambush with the last hit. 5 points go up.
Ambush certainly got her money's worth on that scoring pass, but that is, in fact, a grand slam for Windy City. Windy City pulls within one, can take the lead on this scoring pass. Pack absolutely becalmed on turn three. Now they slowly but surely ooze into the apex. Now they retreat backwards. Power jam has concluded. Fifi Namanon coming from the port side. Hits. Oh, my goodness. That is going to be another back block right directly on Fifi Namanon. Sent back to the notorious RED penalty box. Power jam once again for Windy City Rollers.
And a big one here for Windy City. Sarah Heupel sitting down with Fifi Namanon. Windy City going to lose a blocker in Tamikaze, but they still have the skater advantage and the jammer advantage.
And Josie through for another grand slam. Windy City now up to the tune of 31-22.
It's a big addition for Windy City in Josie. It's her first time at a tournament. First time recently being added to the team. Great strength from Josie. Just throwing a shoulder in and there out for 5 big points.
I doubt we're going to get another scoring pass in. Power jam is concluded. Fifi Namanon in the pack. Jam is going to run out due to its natural expiration date. And it does appear that when all said and done, there's going to be 2 more points added to Texas. It's going to be 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24, 36-24,
right now. Good, not super low scoring. We're seeing some runs coming from both of these teams right now, 36-24. And you can talk to us if you're seeing something that you would like us to mention on hashtag talk to WFTDA. Simon Ream says, called in sick to work so I could watch this Texas versus Windy bout, and we're glad that you're joining us.
And speaking of joining us on and now off the jammer line, that's number 25, Varla Vendetta in the white of the Windy City Rollers. Her opposite number for the Texecutioners is 03, OJ. That's Olivia Scooten-John, and OJ is in fact lead jammer Texecutioners.
OJ really come up these last couple years as a jammer to watch. She has had some big games for Texas, and they would love for her to break one open, but right there, she's going to break from jamming and head on off to the notorious RED penalty box for a back block, Norm.
Seen a few back blocks. That was literally a back block. She blocked another skater in the back with her back.
Yeah, no confusion on that one right there. Smarty Pants getting low on Varla.
And Pack is going to be thinning out as the notorious RED penalty box is going to accept Barbara Ambush of the Texecutioners. But still, Varla Vendetta struggling to get past that front most Texecutioners blocker. Does, though, grand slam 5 points, Windy City.
Wow, the whistle's coming like crazy. Smarty Pants being called on a penalty and then getting the in sub on top of it. So it'll be a full minute in the box for a skater who rarely gets those kind of penalties at number five.
Pack is now slowed to a crawl between turns one and two. Forward motion almost now stops. Drill, a struggle, and around on just a bit of a crack up inside, on the outside. Grand slam, Varla Vendetta, Windy City Rollers.
Windy City, great control right here. They've got all four out front. They're keeping that square. Now a two-wall, making OJ work really hard. Big hit coming in from Sargentina as Kenichi Wow has her held up using every part of her body. And finally, she gets around, puts up 4 points for Texas.
It looks like number 22 for the Texecutioners taking a seat. That's Polly gone. Looks like Barbara Ambush back in the notorious RED penalty box. 4 more points for Varla Vendetta. Power jam has concluded. OJ in danger of being trampled to death in that pack. Oh, my goodness.
Big takeout right there, and that will be a low block on Trauma. Trauma already 3 trips to the notorious RED penalty box. Same for Barbara Ambush, who is seated right now. It says we got Polygon in there as well, and Smarty Pants. A lot of penalties on Texas. One of the things, as we were talking in the announcer's room last night about what would be the keys for these two teams to win, and one thing that came up was Texas so good at keeping it clean. Windy City got the early lead. They have the lead right now, 50-32, and they're really getting under the skin of Texas, forcing them into a ton of penalties. Given Windy City's had their penalty troubles as well, but that's mostly on the back of Bork, 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 who has 3 trips. But on the other side, untimely penalties going to Texas early in this game, Nora.
That is not Texas's game. For the duration of the 2013 playoff season, Texas was always, absolutely always, the least penalized team, sometimes by a great margin, sometimes by almost a factor of two. Texas forces other teams into penalties and then, you know, run roughshod over them. It's uncharacteristic to see them forced into a lot of early penalties like this.
Yeah, they're getting a taste of their own medicine. I remember seeing Windy City last year up against Gotham. They did that same thing. They got under Gotham's skin, forced them into penalty trouble, and took advantage of it. Right now, Windy City doing that to Texas. Be right back to play in a second as we're in an official timeout. I'd like to thank Bont, FXX Wheels, hottest wheels on the market, hotter than anything you got, Quad Star certified, cutting-edge technology, Bont.
And it appears that this timeout is just about on the verge of conclusion. Last time these teams met was last year. It was a narrow 3-point back and forth victory for Windy City. And so they're giving us the high sign. And now an official timeout called on top of the team timeout, which had been called earlier.
So as we are granted more time to thank our sponsors, we'll do just that. S1 Helmets. Check out original roller derby content from S1 Helmets at www.youtube.com/S1RollerDerby.
First time these two teams met was back at the Texas Shootout. That was the 2007 championships in Austin. That was the only time Texas beat Windy City. They won by a margin of 108-56. Texas coming in as a 2 seed, knocking out Windy City, who came in as a 3 seed, same seedings as they have here. Texas returned the favor the next year at the Northwest Knockdown, which is still one of the funnest tournaments I've ever been at. The championships at Portland, Chicago knocking out Windy City en route to a second place finish, and we are off. Or darn close to it.
We're prepared to be off. Haas the Boss with the star up against Ying O Fire. 55 versus 777 here. And a track cut forced on Ying O Fire. It's a power jam now for Haas the Boss.
That's nice footwork by Haas the Boss. She was able to dislodge her opponent from in-play conditions, spin around her. And speaking of spinning there, like you said, lead jammer Haas the Boss to Executioners.
Smarty Pants back on the track. Ambush sat. Polygon back as well. And now Trauma headed to the box. It's a rotating door of Texas skaters going into the notorious RED penalty box. Meanwhile, 3-wall up front has Haas the Boss locked up, killing time off this power jam.
We've got Windy City with all their blockers off of the notorious RUD penalty box. Ying O'Fire now returns, finds herself behind a fairly animated 2-0, finds a gap between the players, gets out on her scoring pass. Hoss the Boss already in the back and scoring, getting a little bit of attention from Jackie Daniels. Jackie Daniels going to turn her free, and that is a four-point scoring pass for Texas.
Meanwhile, in the pack, scrambling back and forth with some of the fastest feet I have ever seen. Yang O'Fire finally breaking out. They made her work, but geez, if you put her on the piano from big and she just wrote a concerto, Norb.
Well, I guess none can ask fairer than that, my goodness. So 4 points were traded there. We have got ourselves, what do you call that, AK, when you got a 45 and a 54 on there?
That would be a palindrome, and it's a palindrome break brought to us by Radar Wheels. Did Hannah see bees? Hannah did. Radar palindrome. Hashtag hive mind.
Dr. Awkward. Anyway, 54 for Windy City, 45 for Texas. Single-digit lead now for the skaters from Chicago. And returning to the Fast Girl Jammers, Fast Girl Skates Jammer line, that's number 108. That is Fifi Nominat in the black of Texas.
And Jen Trainer, the former Griefer Sutherland, one of the few transfers to come over from the Chicago outfit to the Windy City Rollers.
I think the outfit supplied Rocky Mountain with more skaters than it did their crosstown rivals.
Mathematically, yes, that is correct.
Fifi Nominat is on her scoring pass. She is not lead jammer. There was an improper pass in there. She is soon to pass Jan Trainer. Jan Trainer cannot contend with this complete Geometry Wars braced diamond mayhem, Lucky Charms craziness of Texas. Now they are stopped, absolutely stopped between turns 2 and 3.
And here comes Sergeant Tina to clear things out. Offensive pick, getting all four Texas, but a great job by Texas to respond and force Trainer out.
Trainer's going to have to reset, try to get through that same four-fold wall again.
And right here, Windy City holding up a mirror to Texas again, this time out on the track. They did the exact same thing to Fifi Nominat. A little shot right there at the end. Kenichi Wow and Fifi Nominat running into each other. Not worth a penalty, but definitely you can feel the tension between these two teams, Norm.
I can feel the tension, and I'm glad that's in a metaphorical sense because I do not want to be down on the track feeling the tension in a literal sense. Texas was able to put 5 more on the board. They have cut the lead to 5. It is a 54 for Windy City, 49 for Texas. That's 7 squared. Single scoring pass could tie the game for Texas. Returning to the jammer line for Windy City in the white, that's Sandrine Ranjon. She is paired with Fort Texas. Squishing this way and that way, that's Olivia Shooting John, number 03. Pack is absolutely gobbed up like overly compressed silly putty and or Play-Doh. They're barely getting past turn one, and now out and free. That is OJ Olivia Shooting John, lead jammer, Texecutioners.
Windy City doing a good job to stay out in front. Still only by 5. Texas has closed it up. Going to be a little bit harder as they send a Bet Your Maker to the notorious RD penalty box. And 3 points go up for Texas. We have a 2-point game with 13:40 left in the first half. Thank you for joining us here on WFTDA.TV. I'm AK 40 Ounce with Reverend Norb, bringing you the number 2 versus number 3 semifinal game between Texas and Windy City from a fantastic and wholly enthralling Evansville, Indiana.
It's enthralling as heck, I tell you what. Returning to that Fast Girl Jammers Gates for Windy City, nursing a 2-point lead. That's number 65, Josie. She's going up against number 55, Hoss the Boss, working the inside for the Texecutioners in the black. Hoss the Boss finds a little room on the inside, but it's Josie who's lead jammer. I don't know what kind of wheels Josie's got on her, but I don't think she can keep up with Hoss in the open field. I guess that is going to be a hypothetical thing because Hoss knocks Josie out, then slingshots back out.
Godmother's a roller derby. Show you how it's done. Textbook right there. Knocked her out, dragged her back into the pack. You see that pack respond. It's instantly they saw the scenario played out, and all those skaters know exactly how to react.
That's the kind of play that would look awesome if you were watching it on an Atari 2600 and it was just a bunch of little squares moving around.
Looks pretty awesome on WFTDA.TV, too, I would bet. Next jam going to be brought to us by Fast Girl Skates, fastgirlskates.com. 7 years dedicated to making a faster you.
Marla Vendetta, the jammer for Windy City, getting squashed in the middle of the pack, trying to get around on the outside now. It's Fifi Nominat, 108 for the Texecutioners. Texas in the black, Windy City in the white. Got a back block being issued, and that is on Fifi Namanon, lead jammer, I beg your pardon.
Oh, Polygon headed off to the penalty box. Polygon, a phenomenal blocker, but having some penalty trouble. She is fighting through injury right now, waiting till the end of the season to get it addressed. And you can tell there's not the usual for her to be picking up these kind of penalties.
And an unusually stress-free scoring pass there for Varla Vendetta. She steals four for Texas, 58 for Windy City now. For Windy City. Why would she be stealing for Texas? That would be like, that would be unethical. 58-55 is our score. It's going to be a three-point game now. 1 point added to Windy's wee lead. 11.5 minutes to go in the first period. And returning to the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, that's number 03 into and out of that crouch, Olivia Schutenjohn. Number 777, Ying of Fire, jammer for Windy City right now.
Ying of Fire pushing back and forth. Texas doing such a great job at the back three wall.
And it's OJ, lead jammer to executioners. Ying of Fire still stuck in the pack at turn two. OJ eyeing things up. Got her velocity picked and just had one to beat while everyone was turning their attentions to the Windy City jammer. Grand slam to executioners.
It's a phenomenal job out there by Bittercup, Heupel, and Shortcut to sew up the jammer. Ying of Fire, she is now free. But it took her 40 seconds to get out.
And her escape does, however, call in. Well, not necessarily an early call-off, but it does force a call-off. But that's a nine-point jam for Texas. We have a lead change. Texas sitting at 64, 2-6 power. Windy City with 58. That is a six-point lead for Texas. 10.5 minutes to go in the first period.
Absolutely phenomenal here. This is what we expected from this game. The energy in this room is just, it is tension. There's some cheering going on in the crowd, but almost everybody's sitting there watching completely intently, not getting wrapped up in the motion, just soaking up all the fantastic derby, Norris.
This is the most anticipated bout in the history of bouts, and that's number four, Jan Trainer, the jammer for Windy City. Tries to go to the inside, does go to the outside. She is lead jammer, Windy City Rollers.
Great movement from Haas, the boss, back and forth against those three defenders, gets them spread out, and is now out. But Trainer in there scoring points, knocked to the infield by Pants, and calls it off with three.
Yeah, Smarty Pants forced an early call-off, only 3 points scored there. That's going to bring Windy City within 3 points of Texas. 64-61, now our score, 9.75 minutes to go in the first period.
Well, outside of our major offenders in trauma for Texas, who has four trips to the penalty box and four trips for Pork, three for Ambush and three for Tamikaze. So penalties relatively even. A couple people with one apiece and Fifi Namanon with two.
Sandrine Ranjon back on the jammer line for the Windy City Rollers. Fifi Namanon, the jammer of record for Texas. Fifi Namanon to the outside, then crossing to the inside. She's out, she's through. She is your lead jammer for the Texecutioners.
Fantastic positioning from Fifi Namanon. She skated to the inside to get away from that block, got her shoulder low, and kept her leverage.
Both skaters on a scoring pass. Ranjon in danger of scoring some points. She does not. All 4 points picked up for Texas. 68-61 going to be our score. 7 points separate the two teams. Just under 9 minutes to go in the first period. Returning to the Fast Girl Skates jammer line for Texas, that is at 0-3. Olivia Schutenjohn, she's going up against Josie at 65 in the white for Windy City.
We got two completely different style jammers here. You got OJ, small, fast, and squirmy, and Josie, who's got speed, of course, but just raw power right there pushing up against Barbara Ambush and the rest of that Texas wall.
Yeah, Haas the boss went right where all the Windy City defenders happened to congregate, which was the outside. She thought to take the inside, but Windy City was having none of that. Now she's in a what looks like a Greco-Roman knuckle lock with half the Windy City pack. Lead jammer goes to Josie, Windy City Rollers.
A fantastic job at the back dealing with OJ by Sargentina along with Moby Nips, Bork, and Tamikaze.
A lot of familiar names on the Windy City roster. We barely need a roster. And that's going to conclude in a grand slam. Not necessarily conclude, but that scoring pass. Josie, Windy City Rollers. OJ now out on her scoring pass, looking to stop this scoring rampage.
Tamikaze going to the penalty box for Windy City. They'll tack on another 3 points and take the lead now, 69-68. It's a one-point game with 7 minutes and 33 seconds left in the first half. And we've got a 4-on-3 lined up out in front of Haas, the boss for Texas, and Varla Vendetta for Windy City for this next jam.
I had a vague inkling that this game might be kind of good. And my crazy hunch is beginning to bear fruit, I think.
Here we go. Texas taking the front wall. They do have the skater advantage with Tomikazi in the box for Windy City.
Just mass momentum going on here. Everyone trying to just push piles of people one way or another. There's not a lot of momentum gained nor lost. Looks like one of those tackling dummy drills you see on, you know, high school football fields. Haas, the boss, sneaks through on the inside with a spin. She is your lead jammer to executioners.
Phenomenal footwork from number 55. Works great angles, and once you get her going, she's got some speed. She can really lay on the points, but right there, it's hard to get going. You get run into by the opposing jammer and taken down and out, but a low block now on Jackie Daniels, who was the jammer after receiving the star power jam. Haas the boss in Texas.
I believe that's the first star pass we have seen this evening, and it does not bear fruit for Windy City. And
Haas the boss getting tripped up on her way out. No, she did a back. Well, she did get tripped up, but she committed a back block to cause that to happen. So the power jam will be short-lived for Texas, and now it'll be power jam for Windy City and Jackie Daniels.
Star of stage and screen, Jackie Daniels emerges from the notorious RED penalty box. She's got three Texas defenders with which to contend. She has got three of her own teammates in there opening holes for her. She's out. She's through on her scoring pass now. Track cut is being indicated on Sarah Heupel. She'll take a seat in the penalty box. And a clobbering on the outside sends Jackie Daniels to the outfield.
Yeah, that was Bittercup with that massive hit right there. Coming back and countering against the Windy City offense, which on the previous pass did a great job of coming back from the front. And Jackie Daniels back to the box, second time in this jam. Track cut on the veteran. So it's now, again, a power jam for Haas the boss. Direction of gameplay going to be called against the defender. So now Windy City going to be down their jammer and a blocker.
That's going to be a grand slam, a five-point scoring pass actually for each team. That's going to maintain the status quo in some way, shape, or form. It's going to be 74-73, one-point lead for Windy City, 5 minutes to go in the first period.
So folks on Twitter talking to us at hashtag talk, the number 2 WFTDA, want to know why Windy skaters have things written on their legs. Well, they are missing some of their family. Actually, the family is expanding or at least contracting in a different way, however you want to look at it. Howie Rolson, one of the coaches of the Second Wind and longtime favorite Athena DeCrime, getting married this weekend. Our best to them. Howie, love you, brother. Congratulations. You guys are fantastic people and a big part of Windy City, so that's why they had to wrap them here in Evansville.
And congratulations are in order for Fifi Namanon, who has obtained lead jammer for Windy City, who are ahead by 1 point the last time I was talking and are ahead by, for Texas. 78 now. Texas take the lead. That is a lead change. Jackie Daniels now back again from the notorious RED penalty box. Battling her way through every available Texas defender.
Stellar bit of offense being played out of the box. Kenichi Wow out there with Moby Nibs, Vet Your Maker, and Jackie Daniels, who is still jamming, coming out of that penalty trip in the last jam. 4 points going up for Texas. That's going to make it 82-74. We've got 3:45 plus one left in the first half of gameplay. And we're going to take a quick second to thank Rollerbones. Extend your skating career. Wear TSG protective gear. Rollerbones.com for more information.
8 point lead now for Texas, who will send number 03, Olivia Shooting John, back to the Fast Girl Skates jammer line. She is paired up in the white and the flag oriented trim for Windy City Rollers. That is 777 Ying O Fire.
Olivia Shooting John pushing right into that wall and pushing it down. It breaks apart, springs right back up. It's stripped again, springs back up again. Lead jammer, OJ.
Wow, Sergeant Tina put a nice hit on Texas but could not spring her blocker before OJ was sprung. That's going to result in a double zero. Goose eggs across the board. 3 minutes to go. 8 point lead maintained by Texas.
This next jam going to be brought to us by Roll Line, a new generation of roller derby. Roll Line, proudly made in Italy. You can find more about them on the Italian internet, roll-line.it.
Haas the boss taking the jammer line for Texas. Jan Trainer taking the jammer line for Windy. Windy trailing by 8.
See Texas out in front, full packs on the track. Meanwhile, Windy City playing from out in front of that Fast Girl jam line. It's working to their advantage right now, but not a whole lot of advantage being gained by either jammer, Norm.
No, it's a struggle just to get to turn one. That is a Jan Trainer struggles again. Gets midway to the apex. Massive struggle now. Everybody pairing off like very close quartered Sharks and Jets. Two Wall of Texas still working over Jan Trainer. There's now Brace. They've got three players directly on her, plus a out-of-bounds line.
Trainer already picked up lead, but got reabsorbed and still pushing against that Texas Wall.
And the pack has slowly but surely migrated to turn three. Got 54 seconds gone in the jam.
And Snail's pace in this one right here. Think it'd be a little bit easier for Trainer out there as Texas has lost one of their blockers, but everybody else has found the extra little bit of strength to make more Wall out of those three players. They're extending themselves.
Who's your mom is going to take in the seat in the notorious RUD penalty box for skating out of bounds. Lead jammer is still Jan Trainer. No jammers out anywhere. Haas the boss goes backwards, gets a little bit of breathing room. She scoots forward, and that, of course, will necessitate a call-off. So after 2 minutes of virtual struggle, no points scored on that one, AK.
Yeah, that was absolutely incredible. It's rare you see two teams grind it out like that for that long. So rare. I don't think I've ever seen it to that extent before, Norm.
That is some manner of constipation made flesh. 8-point lead still enjoyed by Texas. Got 45 seconds back left in the period. This will very likely be our last jam. And on that jammer line for Texas, it is Fifi Nomenon going up against number 24, Sandrine Ranjon for the Windy City Rollers.
24, the number of points already scored by Fifi Nomenon as well as Sandrine Ranjon's number. Sandrine Ranjon's number indeed is what Texas has, only 4 points so far. However, Fifi Nomenon has a problem of her own dealing with the number four. That's four trips to the box.
That means it's a power jam for Windy City. And the lead jammer, in fact, goes to Sandrine Ranjon and the Windy City Rollers.
And I do stand corrected. It's three trips to the box for Fifi Nomenon. The Ringster folks are faster than I am.
Well, everybody's faster than I am, so it's not a problem. Grand Slam, Windy City. They have brought this down to a 3-point lead. Windy can take the lead on this scoring pass. Worthy cards to be played correctly. Then again, we saw much fruitless struggle in the previous jam, but more fruit for this struggle. 5 points for Windy City. Windy City take the lead now, 84-82.
Ranjon had not scored since the first jam out that she jammed in. She had 4 points there, and now more than doubling her total.
She has spun to a corner four, almost colliding with referee Stanley McDudrow. Fifi Nomenon now out on her scoring pass. Game clock down to zero. Not surprisingly, that is called, and that is going to end the scoring for the first period with Windy. There would have been three more points for Windy City, so 87-82 is going to be our score as we head to the half.
Windy City retaking the lead right at the end there. Great game so far here on WFTDA.TV. This is the last game of the day. This is a semifinal. The winner will be going up against London tomorrow and going to the WFTDA champs. The loser will have to fight against Jacksonville. Windy City came out strong, Norm. After that, Texas fought back. We've lead changed several times, four times by my count, if I'm not mistaken. And right at the end there, Windy City retaking the lead. We've got a 5-point game. You can basically throw out the first half because essentially it's one scoring pass. Basically tied. What to say right now about this game except for we should just like cut to halftime right now on WFTDA TV, let you get a quick break, get a snack, and come back for the last 30 because it's all going to come down to that.
AK cares. Back to the International 2014 Women's Flat Track Derby Association Division I Playoffs live from Evansville, Indiana. Brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and the Demolition City All-Stars, Roller Derby rather. And our halftime entertainment AK consisted of people beating on stuff, and our game consists of people beating on each other. What can you tell me about this game between the number two seed, the Texas Roller Girls Texecutioners, and the number three seeds, Windy City Rollers?
Well, numbers is what I'm going to bring you right now. Looking at the numbers for the first half, pretty even on the penalties. 22 trips to the box for both teams. The big difference has been 5 trips to the box for Texas has been the jammer. Only 2 power jams for Texas, with Windy City sitting twice as the jammer. 14 leads for Texas, only 11 leads for Windy City. Windy City, however, leads on the scoreboard, 87-82. Looking at our leading scorers, Haas the Boss leads all with 38 points. Fifi Nominon adding 24 to Texas's total, and then 20 for Olivia Shootin' John. On the other side of the scoreboard, Dr. Joseph L. Simonis, the new addition, coming in 28 points in the first half for Windy City. 16 points for Varla Vendetta, 17 for Sandrine Ranjan, 9 for Yingo Fire, and 10 for Jackie Daniels.
We were expecting to see a pretty deep jammer, not rotation, but a jammer core, if you will, for both of these teams. That's how they operate. They don't do the 1-2 punch. They don't do a strict 3 jammer rotation. Everybody knows they go deep in their jammer rotations, and they probably have to because everybody's getting so pummeled going through the pack.
Yeah, we've seen a lot of energy expended, especially in the one jam where you had Haas the Boss out there for Texas, and I believe it was Ying of Fire. It was going up against those opposing walls. It was basically the entire jam that they were out there and fighting. Haas the Boss finally sprung free with just about 15 seconds left, and lead had been awarded to Varla, so she called it off at that point. But that has been pretty symptomatic of this game. It's been close, very tight game, of course, with a 5-point lead right now in favor of Windy City as we start the second half. Of course, the winners will go on to face London tomorrow at 6 o'clock Central. The losing team will go on to face Jacksonville for the third spot at the WFTDA Championship Weekend. That will be in Nashville, Tennessee, starting on Halloween.
And the winner of this game does indeed scan their ticket for championships in Nashville. The loser is going to have to fight their way through Jacksonville for a third-place finish to advance.
So before we get started, I'd like to thank Adam Wheels
Adam is a proud partner of the WFTDA. 6 years running. Visit AdamWheels.com for all of their fantastic products.
Windy City apparently not had enough contact during normal gameplay. They're now slapping each other in the back. I guess whatever gets you through the night works. Returning to the Fast Girl Skates Jammerwine, that's number 55, Hoss the Boss for the Texecutioners from Austin, Texas, wearing the black. She will be paired up with number 65, Josie, in the white of the Windy City Rollers All-Stars.
Josie, a homegrown new addition to Windy City, had the opportunity by proxy to hear about their exploits while Josie was playing with the second win earlier this season. The B team for Detroit went out there, and everything I heard when I asked about that game was, watch out for number 65. They'll be coming up soon. They're going to make a huge impact on the Windy City Rollers All-Stars. So far, that has been the case. Again, 28 points, leading all scorers for Windy City.
If it's your first year skating with the travel team and you are scoring 28 points and a half on Texas, I would say you might have a bright future in roller derby.
Indeed. Of course, Hoss the Boss, a more recent addition than a lot of the Texas players, a lot of vets on the Texecutioners. Haas really broke out last year and is having a fine night thus far. Here we go with the second half.
And speaking of breaking out, your lead jammer for Windy City, enjoying a five-point lead, that is Josie.
Sarah Heupel being called on a multiplayer block, so only a three-wall out there now to deal with Josie. Getting taken down there by Fifi Nominon.
Fifi Nominon, one of those players that plays on both sides of the ball, as it were, offense and defense with equal aplomb and vigor. Fifi Nominon still on Josie, trying to truncate that scoring pass and will indeed force them back to the back of the pack as Jackie Daniels picks up another trip to the notorious RED penalty box for Windy.
So both pivots in said notorious RED penalty box as Haas the Boss has broken out and is eligible to score. But Josie not going to let that happen. We'll call it off. And they picked up 5 points for Windy City, extending the lead now 10 points, 92-82, with 1 minute gone in the second half.
I'd like to thank all parties involved for making the math simple. Returning to the Fast Girl Skates Jammerline, that is number 03. That is Olivia Shooting John for Texas in the black. She's paired up with number 25 in the white to the Windy City Rollers. That is Varla Vendetta.
Out in front of Varla Knichiwau with Moby Nibs, Bork, 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 and Jackie Daniels sitting in the box. Opposing them will be Sarah Heupel, Polygon, Molotov, Ampale, and Barbara Ambush.
Vendetta feigns to the left, but it does her no good. Lead jammer Olivia Shooting John, Texas Roller Girls.
As I mentioned, OJ, 20 points in the first half. Had a decent showing. Had some trouble, though, right there. Not a lot of trouble. A little bit of resistance forces her to call it off with just 2 points going up on the board, but every single point is going to count in this game. 8 is the difference right now.
Yeah, it looked like Windy City were of the opinion that OJ might have come in a little hot in turn one, but be that as it may, the referees do not concur, nor do they add credence to the assertion. So, 92-84 is where we're going to stay. Both jammers in a crazy crouch right now, AK.
Yeah, out on the Fast Girl Skates start line, we will have Smarty Pants taking a turn with the star out against Ying Oh Fire. Ying Oh Fire held up, and Smarty Pants is lead for the Texecutioners.
Ying Oh Fire had no luck getting through the inside. She springs back and finds the outside relatively clear. However, points already being scored by Smarty Pants for the Texecutioners. Ying Oh Fire coming up on the back of that pack, but that pack is not unnoticed by Smarty Pants. He's going to trust her defense. You see Texas do this sometimes. They will risk having their point differential erased.
And the dice roll pays off. Hits a critical right there as Texas has forced a track cut on Ying Oh Fire. So it is a power jam for Smarty Pants and the Texecutioners. Ooh, and it's getting a little bit easier with Sergeant Tina headed to the notorious RED penalty box.
Smarty Pants is going to have to come in at the rear of turn two. She has got a two-wall of a... And a forearm is being assessed, and that is going to go on Smarty Pants. It is now going to be a rather brief power jam for the Windy City Rollers.
Varla Vendetta feeling sure of herself, hands raised in the notorious RD penalty box as she has sprung with Smarty Pants sitting. First half saw quite a few jams with numerous jammer penalties, uncharacteristic of these two teams.
Ying Oh Fire really struggling with those frontmost Texas defenders. Shortcut, and now she's joined by number 813 Bittercup, and had been joined for quite some time
by Trauma right there, who just recently joined Texas. Of course, Those who know Derby, no trauma. And from the KCRW.
Power Jam has concluded. Smarty Pants. Oh, my goodness. Smarty Pants clearing out, carving out a hole in the veritable granite of the Windy City Pack. Struggling with Jackie Daniels. Now she just beats the Pack by inches. She has still got the two foremost Windy defenders with which to contend.
Yeah, she got a little bit of a break there. Zingo Fire was down. Jackie tripped over, but a great recycle, getting Windy City out in front, forcing the call off, and an even up 5-5 Jam makes it 97-93. 4-point game. Windy City leading with 25 minutes and 37 seconds.
Returning to that fast girl skates jammer line for Windy City, that is number 24, Sandrine Ranjon. She is going up against number 55 in the black of the Texecutioners. That's Hoss the Boss.
Two very evenly matched jammers, both with great mobility and great speed, not finding either right now as they're sewn up by these defenses, but Sandrine Ranjon out with lead jammer.
Yeah, inside was open all the while, but nobody took it. Nobody could actually get to it. Sandrine Ranjon right now on her scoring pass. She pierces through that three wall of Texas. Black actually for once makes a pack pass look relatively easy. Grand slam, Windy City.
The dust has been shaken off by Ranjon. She has been skating this whole time, has not been playing much derby, but the instincts are returning. Great job hitting the seam right there and picking up 4 points for WCR, extending their lead, crossing the century mark, and putting the total of 106 up on the scoreboard to Texas's 93.
13-point lead now for Windy City, 24 and a half minutes to go. You're watching on WFTDA.TV.
Easy for us to say.
Easy for someone to say. Returning to that fast girl jammer, fast girl skates jammer line, which is also very easy for me to say. That is number four. That is Jan Trainer for the Windy City Rollers and 03 Olivia Shootin' John for the Texecutioners. Sargentina having none of that go-through-the-middle business from OJ. Meanwhile, Jan Trainer getting recycled to the back of the pack where she will face a braced pyramid of Texas defenders. And the front of the pack, that's where the business is happening. However, lead jammer goes to Olivia Shootin' John from the Texecutioners.
Trainer out as well and making short work of the real estate between those two jammers. Will not make it back around, though. Stopped by a Jackie Daniels, but 3 points going up for Texas. They will inch closer. 106 on the board for Windy City, 96 for Texas. Quick announcer math means 10-point lead.
23 and a half minutes to go in this battle to see who will take on the London Roller Girls tomorrow for first place in this miraculously wonderful championship tournament.
And both of these teams coming in. The thing you got to realize, obviously, they both want to play for first. But having it off your shoulders that you're going to Nashville out of this game would be so much easier than having to go face a very tough team in Jacksonville tomorrow.
Speaking of tough lead jammers for the Windy City Rollers, that is Josie. Jammer for Texas still mired in a pack which has no intentions of going anywhere. That's number five, Smarty Pants. Smarty Pants in danger of becoming a lap point. Not if the Texas defense has anything to say about it at the rear of the pack. Now we see Windy City attempting to go and spring their jammer. And everyone moving into one gigantic bulk of humanity at the apex between turns one and two.
Smarty Pants being reset to the back. And Sarah Heupel doing a phenomenal job out there against Dr. Ms. Joseph L. Simonis, who plows over Heupel, just bossing up on everybody, using the physicality and picking up 5 points.
I think Sarah Heupel had gotten one too many licks in there for Josie's liking. Looks like Bork, Bork, Bork taking a seat in the notorious RED penalty box. Both jammers free now.
That was Polygon getting out in front. Josie enforcing the call off, and at the last second, Smarty sneaks in. Tied up on that pass, 2-2, makes it 113 Windy City, 98 for Texas.
15-point lead for Windy City now. They will send number 25 to the jammer line. That is Varla Vendetta. She's going up against number 55 in the black of the Texecutioners. That's Hoss the Boss.
Hoss the Boss, 38 points thus far in this game. Varla Vendetta, 21 points for Windy City.
Inside of that pack being left deceptively open by both defenders, but once someone tries to get over there, they cut off that angle, making it rather difficult to commute. Which I guess if you're dealing with Chicago, that's the way it works. Lead the jammer does go to Hoss the Boss, Texecutioners.
And parking's really expensive. getting parked on the infield for a second was Varla Vendetta. Compliments of Barbara Ambush. And right here, being ground to the inside like fine Colombian coffee by Fifi Nominon, again, is Varla Vendetta as 5 points go up for Haas the Boss.
Haas the Boss ready to embark on another scoring pass. She hits the back of the pack. She sails into Jackie Daniels, who stops her in her tracks. Also, Hoosier Mama and the rest of the Texas squad, three of them engaged in a brace to tripod, retarding her progress. We've got one Windy City defender.
So Hoosier bridging back. Meanwhile, Hoosier's up front, I'm sorry, with Sargentina and Jackie Daniels making Haas really work for it. Sarge going to get Haas into the infield. They'll come back, cause chaos, and give some room for Varla.
Yeah, when Sargentina got destabilized, fell small, that allowed Haas, the Boss, to spring free. That's going to be a grand slam for Texas. Texas now within 5 points. Varla Vendetta now out on her scoring pass. Texas looking to cut this lead to perhaps 1 point on this scoring pass. I would not imagine they will score more than that. Haas calls it off from her knees on turn four. 3 points stolen by Windy City as the jam is called with 2 points for Texas there.
Yeah, Haas was down on the outside just a half second too slow on the call, and a great job. Big smile from Varla Vendetta as she ekes an extra point out of that pack. 116 Windy City, 110 for Texas. We are under 20 minutes left in this game in today, and it has been an interesting day. A lot of great games, this one no exception.
Number 777, Yetsying of Fire, trying to sideways herself through the pack for Windy City. She's paired up with OJ for the Texecutioners. Ying of Fire gets knocked down towards the right side straight away from my vantage point. Whistles are blowing. We've got Olivia shooting John, stumbling over another skater. Does not look like penalties will be assessed. Either way, lead jammer OJ Texecutioners.
Great effort there from Tomikaze to get her to the outfield, but OJ knows the angles of this track as well as anybody. Cut hard to the inside. Heupel now going into the notorious RD penalty box. So it's a 3-on-3 as OJ's on a scoring pass.
Ying of Fire being held up there by number 22 of the Texecutioners. Polly gone. That's going to result in a grand slam for Texas, courtesy of OJ.
One point game
now. Yes, great mind thinks alike. Think alike. OJ hits the pack. We'll see how many fingers go out here, but we may have affected a lead change.
OJ looking for the call off from her knees, but cut the track, and it's a power jam now for Windy City. Points may have been scored by Texas, so the score will need to be updated when she gets out of the box. Meanwhile, Windy City still with the 1 point lead. Star pass here going to Konichi Wow, and 4 points are added to the total for Windy City.
Konichi Wow now ready on her solo scoring pass. Texas setting up a braced tripod up in front. They've also got one lone agent, that's number 19. Molotov Impale trying to stop Konichi Wow doing. Konichi Wow is running up against Sarah Heupel. Heupel's going to head to the notorious RED penalty box on that. Heupel sits. Power jam does conclude. Olivia shooting John out of the penalty box for Texas.
Some fantastic positioning from Polly Gon out there to help Texas hold back Konichi. Well, another back block. Second in this jam for Olivia shooting John. Power jam will continue. Texas is going to lose another blocker right at the end. They've got Heupel sitting with 5 trips. She'll be joined by number 8, 12, cease and desist.
Texas got 1 point out of that when all was said and done. Out of that pass, 5 points scored by Windy City.
Sorry, that was 8-13 Bitter Cup.
Windy City Bitter with 125. Cup. Texas 116, and that's a 9-point lead. 17 and a half to go.
So a full box of Texecutioners and a 9-point lead for Windy City with 17 and a half left. Windy City's got to be feeling very good about their performance so far. They are back on the upswing, but right now, a little bit of concern has to be going through the back of their minds as Ying of Fire is on the ground and being looked at by the medical staff just to the left of your screen if you're watching. If you're not, just listening, thank you for joining us, but why aren't you watching this game? Unless you are physically unable or at work or something, pay the money, get the pass, and do not miss any of the action tomorrow. We have some fantastic games lined up, as we have mentioned. Starting things out, 10 a.m., it'll be Ohio versus Houston for 9th. Steel City versus Toronto will be after that. Then we will see Nashville versus Arizona, Jacksonville versus the loser of this game, and London opposing the winner of this game for the gold medals and the bye at the WFTDA Championships.
Speaking from personal experience, being at work is no excuse for watching roller, not watching roller derby. Jammer of record, that's number 24, lead jammer for Windy City, that is Sandrine Ranjon. Enjoying the fruits of a power jam, Texas is going to get one more blocker as Sarah Heupel returns from the notorious RED penalty box. A direction of gameplay penalty is going to be sending number 999 Evetcher Maker to said box, but not before a grand slam can be scored for Windy City.
Texas coming back, resetting as Ranjon gets in, finds room on the inside line. Polygon swing and a miss. And 5 points, a grand slam. Not often do you get a swing and a miss in a grand slam, but you get it right here in roller derby.
I never thought of it that way. Power Jam has concluded, and OJ is on her initial scoring pass. Jackie Daniels taking another trip to the notorious RED penalty box. 4 points scored and a call-off for Ranjon. That is going to bolster the score to 139 for Windy City, 116 for Texas. That is a 23-point lead as it stands. 16 and a half minutes to go in the rapidly moving second period.
Indeed. Quick look at penalties. Sarah Heupel knocking on heaven's door. 6 trips to the notorious RED penalty box. Livy Shoot, John, Fifi Nominon, Polygon, and Smarty Pants, along with Bittercup, all with 3 for Texas. Trauma and Barbara Ambrose with 4. I'll give you the Windy City update after this jam.
And speaking of Smarty Pants, she is the jammer for the Texecutioners right now. She's paired with Jan Trainer for the Windy City Rollers. She's struggling with 2 Windy City defenders. In fact, Smarty Pants is lead jammer. Jan Trainer is in front of her. We will see how this is going to be played by the occasionally dice-rolling Texas Roller Girl. She is going to call it off, make the conservative play. Nothing, nothing. 139 to 116 remains our score.
Okay, so looking at penalties for Windy City, Jackie Daniels and Bork, 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 both with 5, sits in the notorious RED penalty box. 4 for Vet Your Maker and Tamikaze, who's your mama with 3, as well as Sergeant Tina. And outside of that, nobody in trouble. You got 2 for Ying of Fire, but unfortunately for Ying of Fire, she's got different trouble to deal with. She is being looked at, and we are going to say with much assuredness she will most likely not be returning to this game. We'll get an update if we can on her condition. Meanwhile, she's getting her foot wrapped up right now. We hope a speedy recovery. We'd love to see her back in this game, as would Windy City, but it is not looking likely with 15:39 remaining.
And that concludes our official timeout. Returning to the Fast Girl Skates jammer line for the Texecutioners. That's number 55. That is Hoss the Boss. She is paired with number 65. That's Josie in the white with the blue and red trim of the Windy City Rollers. Everybody straight up the middle, which is where everybody else is. Center of the pack completely clogged with skaters. Now things break up as they go around the apex. Lead jammer is, in fact, Hoss the Boss of Texas, who is knocked down in the infield at turn 2. She is now no longer the jammer in the lead and realizes this fact, calls it off. No points scored once again.
Yeah, Hoss the Boss slathered across the floor there by Sergeant Tina, getting a high five from Jackie Daniels as well as Tamikaze for that big hit. They're fired up. They look loose. You know, Norm, looking over at the benches, Windy City, they got smile on their faces. They're looking loose. Texas looking very focused. Everybody sitting there, just eyes on the prize right now. They do trail by 23 points, 139 to 116.
Texas not really known for breaking from that game phase during intense moments of gameplay. Speaking of Texas, their jammer is number 3, and that is Olivia Shootin' John. She is paired with number 24, Sandrine Ranjon of the Windy City Rollers. Ranjon at the back of the pack now. Tries to get around on the outside. She has got 1 defender to beat. That's Fifi Nominon. Beat her. She does. Lead jammer, Windy City Rollers.
A great effort from some of the Texas blockers out there, but Ranjon gets going, and she gets some space. Give her a foot, and she'll kick you in the behind.
Texas jammer now out and free on her scoring pass. That is OJ looking to either steal points or at the very least necessitate an early jam call-off. And points steal she does. That is 1 point stolen by Texas on that go-round. 4 points scored by Windy City Rollers. So Windy City is going to add 13 points to that lead. It's now 143 to 117. That is 26 points in Windy City's favor. 13 and 3/4 minutes to go in this period.
You're watching WFTDA.TV. I'm AK40 Ounce. He's Reverend Norb. This is Windy City versus Texas, number 2 versus number 3 in reverse order of how they announced them.
from the beautiful Ford Center here in Evansville, Indiana. Jam is on.
And number 5, Smarty Pants, is the jammer for the Texecutioners. Number 25, Varla Vendetta, jammer for Windy City Rollers.
Varla Vendetta, great push on the outside, but goes down on the inside. And that buys time for lead jammer to be awarded to Texas.
Still a no-go for Varla Vendetta, who is attempting a star pass. Looks like we have the star stash hocus pocus shell game. Varla Vendetta has got that star back on her head. She remains the jammer.
Smarty Pants spinning around against those defenders and calls it off just before Varla gets back in. Varla coming in hot and high, holding her face right there. Ran into the back of one of the Texecutioners. Getting looked at briefly. Just got shook up, no major damage. Shrugs it off and heads back to the bench.
Refuses treatment as if it is some sort of blemish on her mark of awesomeness. Apparently she'll be all right. Going to be 143 for Windy City, 119 for Texas. That's a 24-point lead. Back on the fast girl jammer skates. That's number 4 in the white of the Windy City Rollers. That's Jan Trainer. She is paired up with Hoss the Boss, number 55 of the Texecutioners. Got a direction of play penalty. That is going to send Barbara Ambush out to the notorious RED penalty box as the pack breaks up a bit around the second turn. We've got a forearm being indicated on the pivot for Windy City and lead jammer Hoss the Boss, the Texecutioners.
So Kenichi Wow going to go take a seat along with Barbara Ambush. It'll be 3-on-3 as Hoss approaches the pack.
Texas trusting their blockers now. Points already being scored in there for Windy City by Trainer. Trainer is going to have to recycle back on turn 3.
A fine job by Bittercup on that first attempt right now. Heupel out there keeping it slow with Molotov and Pale. Meanwhile, Haas the Boss not finding a lot of room, but she does get just past on the outside.
Trainer fighting for her life in that Texas pack, trying not to get encapsulated by that diamond defense. Haas the Boss, tries to squirm right around. That's going to cause a collision. Does not look like... We've got penalties assessed, point of fact, I beg my pardon.
Haas the Boss got folded like some going out money by Ruth and Asia. She sprung right back up, but that could not have been a pleasant experience.
Haas the Boss still trying to battle through the interior of the pack. And Haas the Boss is through for a 5-point pass. That is a grand slam for the Texecutioners.
And Barbara Ambush back to the notorious RED penalty box, or at least on her way. That is her 6th trip. Now they have 2 skaters sitting on 6, her and Sarah Heupel, who have been so good together.
Trainer hits the pack now, followed by Haas the Boss. Gets through. 4 points for Windy City. Whistles blow. No points scored on that last scoring pass by Texas. That's going to put us at 147 to 132. 15-point lead for Windy City. Little under 10.5 minutes to go in the game.
Nice effort from Texas to bring it back in a little bit. This next jam going to be brought to us by Derby for All. Experience Derby skaters getting you the right gear to take you to the next level. That's Derby, the numeral 4all.com.
OJ on the fast girl skates, jammer line for the Texecutioners. Sandrine Ranjon on the jammer line for the Windy City Rollers.
Two of my absolute favorites to watch, and I know those sentiments are echoed by a lot of people out there. Both very scrambly jammers. You see Ranjon working back and forth, getting Texas to bite and give her space.
That was scrambliness personified. Dashed around everybody, and it was not an economy of movement there. She moved left and right and wiggled and jiggled. Now she's spinning right. She is lead jammer. And that's going to cause a track cut power jam for the Texecutioners.
Yeah, a little too scrambly on that turn to the inside. Meanwhile, big clearing block from Fifi Nominon. But Sargentina comes back around and then gets taken down herself. Soul crushed back, and they're going to have to reset.
Sargentina and Sarah Heupel battling in that pack for their respective teams. We got a forearm penalty, and that is going on. Texas's jammer. The power jam now goes to Windy City as OJ takes a seat in the notorious RED penalty box.
Yeah, she'll cool her jets right now. 4th trip to the notorious RED penalty box for OJ.
Both teams full strength blocker-wise. They put a little haste in their step as the action approaches the back apex.
Grand John taken out by Barbara Ambush right there. Sargentina looking to provide some assistance out there, getting into a street fight with Fifi Nominon.
Grand John trying the outside, can't find it, finds a hole on the inside, escapes free. That's going to be 5 points for the Windy City Rollers.
Windy City extending their lead now, 156-132. Power jam is over and no lead, so we'll be going the full 2 minutes, which has about 10 seconds left. Good chance for both of these gyms to get in the scoring pass.
I believe points have been scored for both teams. We will see only a couple seconds left in the jam clock right now. 2 points scored for Texas on that go-round. And four for Windy City. So our score is going to be 160 for Windy City, 134 for Texas. That's a 26-point lead enjoyed by Windy City. 7.75 minutes to go in the game.
If you'd like to talk to us, please do. Hashtag talk to WFTDA. Some great comments. There was one earlier. Go back a little bit. Hot feet, sandy pants, so freaking good. I can't even, says Emily Mills. Suki Smackhouse says, I am so glad I stayed up for this. Such a close game. Texas, Texas, kill, kill, kill on the Twitters. Thank you, everybody, for staying up and tuning in. Definitely worth it. Right now, our score, 160 for Windy City, 134 for Texas. Of course, I'm going to bring it back. Historically, Windy City owns this series 5-1. Texas would love to shift that back in their favor and go on, retain their 2 seed, and play London tomorrow. Windy City ever so happy to upset them, Norb.
Well, nothing's upsetting me because everybody loves the number 5, including his Smarty Pants. She is the jammer of record for Windy City on the opposite, excuse me, for Texas on the opposite side of the coin. That is number 65, Joe Z. They are the jammer for the Windy City Rollers and, in point of fact, lead jammer.
And as you are so often apt to do, she loves the number 5, as does Josie. That's 13 times the number 5, 465.
It's also a palindrome jammer lineup, but never mind that. Josie in the pack. Refs say pack here. Refs say no pack. And that is a forearm on Josie. They will be taking a seat in the notorious RED penalty box. It is a power jam for the Texecutioners.
Now this is the second opportunity Smarty Pants has had on a power jam to move things in Texas's way. Great job one-on-one, one-on-one, and one-on-one by the Windy City Pack. They got Jackie Daniels, Kenichi, Wow, Ruth, and Asia, and Yvette, your maker, out there doing the heavy lifting against Smarty Pants, who's on another scoring pass.
All blockers on the track for both teams right now, attempting to squish through the middle of a very staunch two-wall of Windy City. Oh, with a nice spin move, she's out, she's free. That is a grand slam, 5-point pass for Smarty Pants. As the power jam concludes, we get jammer concussive activity between Josie and Haas, Smarty Pants.
What a beautiful maneuver right there by Smarty Pants, mohawking on the outside line, staying in, picking up a second grand slam. Windy City did such a good job during the power jam to hold her back. She gets an easy pass on that last one. Now, not so much. She's being locked up and sent out by Jack Daniels.
Texas absolutely bricked up right there, holding the Windy City jammer at bay. You've got number 999, Yvette, your maker, playing some offensive blocker action type things, trying to freeze that jammer. Everybody now backwards, forwards. Battle is concluding at two different parts of the track, but it results in a grand slam for Texas. Texas within 6 now.
And DeBella DeBall with the big takedown on Josie. Slow to get up. Josie had 3 points, and we've got a 8-point game right now. Windy City 163, Texas 155. We've got 5 minutes, 16 seconds remaining, and we have an official timeout. Time enough to catch your breath, refill your drink for the last 5 minutes of this game. And as we are in an official review, Windy City out there. Somebody earlier on the tweets had said, I'm not sure what is better, this game or Justice Feelgood Marshall's outfit. He's a very, very dapper young gentleman out there.
Verily, he is dapperness made flesh. AK, I don't know about you, but I can't imagine playing in a game like this for a number of reasons. A, I don't skate.
Right.
But even announcing this is just absolutely physically draining, just the focus that these two teams have teeing off on each other, just to try to pick apart all the action. I mean, I feel like I've been going through a meat grinder, and I'm just sitting on a rather comfortable folding chair next to you.
Yeah, it's incredible, and, you know, obviously there are a lot of announcers who would love to be in this position. We are very, very lucky to be here bringing you this game on WFTDA.TV. It's 8 points, 5 minutes left. Winners going to champs. But, yeah, there's so much going on. It's almost too much to keep up with because there's so much great work in the pack from both of these teams. The Jammers, between the penalties and the runs and the big scoring opportunities that they've had, it's just everything you could want about roller derby compressed into one game. I have a feeling this one's going to get a lot of rewatches on the archives, Norm.
It's like things are just splitting off into these little mini rumbles, like an amoeba being broken up into different cells, and then it reforms and then it comes back. It is intense. It's you need about maybe 5 to 6 eyeballs to keep your eyes on all this stuff.
Yeah, most games, you know, they're a bit like Voltron. You've got 5 or 6 different things that come into one. This is like that later Voltron that had about 20 different cars and jets that somehow formed a giant robot of awesome derby action. That's the best metaphor I got because we've got an official review going on right now, and I'm going to take a second to thank Printco Graphics. Lead the pack with new UV ink printing at printcographics.com. And hey, while you're on the internet, why not go over to the WFTDA.com store and get your tournament merchandise right there at WFTDA.com/store. This would be a good t-shirt to have. The memories alone are going to be worth it, but I have a feeling I at least will be picking up some sort of WFTDA merchandise. Thankfully, I won't have to wait for the shipping to come in. I can walk right over there as soon as this is over. And if you are within striking distance of Evansville, Indiana, I suggest you take that midnight train, get here for tomorrow's games, because they're going to be incredible. Double H.
So Texas was looking for a call on a legal re-entry from Windy City's jammer out of the penalty box, and that call is not going to be awarded, guys.
All right. Being awarded to Barbara Ambush, though, is a foul out. 7 trips to the box, and they will no longer be without number 1600.
Haas, the boss, is jammer of record for the Executioners right now, pushing up against a wall of mixed team of players. She's paired with Ranjon for the Windy City Rollers. Gets around on the outside, dashes around Fifi Namanon. Lead jammer, Windy City Rollers, Sandrine Ranjon.
Meanwhile, Haas, the boss, fighting it out, sneaks through on the inside, has about a half track to make up on Ranjon. Ranjon caught the track, tried to stay in, but stepped in. And finally, a little bit of breathing room for Haas, the boss, who's going to have Sargentina and Ranjon sitting in the box. 4-3 pack advantage, and a power jam becomes a 4-2 pack advantage. Is Windy City going to lose another blocker?
Grand Slam has already been accumulated to Texas right now. They can take the lead on this scoring pass. 3 points, apparently, not counting any points scored by Windy City, separates the two teams. And that's going to be a grand slam. 5 points for Texas.
And we have a lead change with 4 minutes and 10 seconds remaining. It's getting loud here at the Ford Center.
Getting almost as loud as the marching band. We have got Bork, 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 and Jackie Daniels in the front of Windy City's pack. In point of fact, they're also at the rear because they're the only two defenders out there. They're holding the wall admirably against number 55, Haas, the boss. Reinforcements come in the form of Sargentina, and Power Jam has concluded, dashing unseen on the inside. That is Sandrine Ranjon back in the fray. She's going to conclude her scoring pass with 4 points. Grand slam, however, for Texas, courtesy of Haas, the boss, with 5 points.
Ain't nobody calling this one off. It's going to run the full time. Haas, the boss, being stuck on this scoring pass. Meanwhile, Ranjon, soul crush to the outside, going to come back and deal with OJ and Shortcut in the back of that pack, along with Fifi Namanon and Bittercup.
Real nice jump move there by Ranjon. She was able to fake Olivia, fake Shortcut out. Got a timeout being called by Windy City. 2 points scored for Texas there. 4 points scored by Windy City.
We will let the math people do the calculations. They have done them. 170 on the board for Texas. 167 for Windy City. But we have an update.
That's going to be 172 for Texas, 171 for Windy City. It's a one-point game. Our main scoreboard on the big thing that hangs over the track and makes you wonder what's going to happen if it ever falls down. That appears to have frozen.
This game is so amazing, it broke the arena, Norb.
That's not the first time I've seen that happen in this tournament, which is odd given the newness of this facility, but roller derby occasionally breaks things. You let them know that at our hotel.
So we have a one-point game. Texas taking the lead in that last one and hanging on by 1 point. We've got 3 minutes, 10 seconds remaining. They added a couple seconds back in with the team timeout. Windy City still has two left. Texas, however, only one timeout remaining, and they have used their official review in this half. So Texas cannot do a lot of time control.
Josie back on the jammer line for the Windy City Rollers, wearing number 65, paired up with number 5. That is Smarty Pants, Indy Black of the Texecutioners. Both jammers put shoulders into each other. They head for opposite sides of the track. Trying to zigzag their way through the outside, now through the interior, and it's going to be a power jam for Windy City. A track cut on Smarty Pants, power jam Windy.
Beautiful job by Sergeant Tina to force the track cut, got her in, and Smarty jumped up, but Sergeant Tina stepped back just in time for the cut. Lead jammer now going to Ms. Dr. Joseph Alsimonis with the finger of power. The rookie has been phenomenal in this game. 61 points. I was looking to ask the boss. 61 points is Sandrine Renjet. 43 points. Either way, it's been stellar.
And Power Jam now concludes. And
we've gone back to this. This is just the grind, the push. Both walls pushing. Great job by Texas to limit the damage on the power jam.
It's like spy versus spy. We've got four black spies against one white spy in the front. Four white spies against one black spy in the front. Pack almost in danger of turning loose between turns 2 and 3. We have got
everybody fighting it out, but out in front, it's going to be Smarty Pants clearing her initial pass. Meanwhile, from the floor, Josie calling it off on a scoring pass. 5-point grand slam for Ms. Dr. Joseph Alsimonis. 176-172. Windy City has retaken the lead. A minute and 33 left in this game. Reverend Norm, please say something.
AK-40 ounce, this is what we derby fanatics live for. Thank you for telling me to speak, otherwise I would have no idea. Actually, I'm rather transfixed. I find myself at a loss for words, which doesn't happen that often, but I can tell you one gall darn thing about it. On and off the fast girl skates jammer line for Texas. That is number 55, Haas the Boss. She's going up against Barla Vendetta for Windy City. We have an elbow being indicated, and that is on Haas the Boss. It is going to be a power jam for Barla Vendetta and the Windy City Rollers.
It's Power Jam brought to us by Rydell Skates. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance. And we will see how the quality and performance of this Power Jam plays out for Varla Vendetta and the Windy City Rollers. Back block being called in the pack. It's going to be Jackie Daniels going to the notorious RED penalty box. And much like in the wedding scene in Spaceball, she will go right past it and out the door. That is 7 trips and a foul out for old number 7.
I guess she's fouled her number. And oh, almost free as Varla Vendetta gets tripped up. Now she must contend with Shortcut. Finally out and free after 50 seconds of intense struggle. Varla Vendetta, your lead jammer. Haas the Boss out of the penalty box. Overtakes Varla Vendetta at turn one.
Haas the Boss being knocked out. Jammer on jammer action sends Haas back. She is going to get eaten right here. Unfortunately for Varla, the Texas blockers were out front. It goes the other way. Texas has reabsorbed Varla Vendetta. Haas the Boss out with room. They're going to let that time get killed right here. But watch out, because here comes Haas the Boss around. 1 point, a jammer lap point, and an unofficial final, 176-173. Windy City has held on to win. We will double check the score just to make sure, but jubilation on the faces of the lady from the City of Wynn. They own Texas 6-1 historically, and they will relegate them to the third and fourth place game to face off against a fierce New Jack City Jacksonville All-Star team tomorrow for third place and the final ticket to Nashville. However, Windy City will face off against London tomorrow, Norb.
I I guess it would go without saying that I can't wait for that game. I actually can't wait. I can't wait for tomorrow to come. I'm wishing myself into the future for, you know, those five fabulous games. I like them all, actually.
As the Jedi would say, be mindful of the present. Soak it in. What an amazing game right before our eyes right here. 176-173. It is still unofficial. We're going to let everything go until the whistle is blown. Meanwhile, arms raised on the side of the Windy City Rollers. How you like that, Howie and Athena? That's a nice little wedding present. Blood, sweat, and tears going into that one. And everybody else back in Chicago. Whistle blows. It's done. And the Windy City Rollers are going to the WFTDA International 2014 D1 Playoff in Evansville Championship tomorrow.
I would say this victory is a much better wedding present than a money tree. Crowd erupting in jubilation, people streaming onto the field, young, old, all alike. It looks like a Ying of Fire is hopping on one leg to make her victory lap. She has got that ankle iced. I don't know if we'll see her tomorrow or not. That is a storyline which bears further witness.
And you can witness it right here on WFTDA.tv. If you've been listening and not witnessing, please do buy the pass. I tell you what, you're going to get five games tomorrow, and it's worth the $12. Are you kidding me? Lined up for tomorrow, we have Ohio versus Houston at 10 a.m. Central, followed by Steel City versus Toronto, Nashville versus Arizona, Jacksonville versus Texas, and London versus the Windy City Rollers, who for the second year in a row defeat Texas by 3 points. How about that?
They are nothing if not consistent. That was an absolutely miraculous game. I feel absolutely emotionally spent, even though I'm just sitting here babbling into a microphone.
Right.
I honestly don't think that we just thought that this game was going to be two teams skating around and, what the hell, just try to score a bunch of points and see how it goes. I mean, we knew it was going to be a battle in the trenches, and Windy City 3 better than Texas when all was said and done.
Yep, and I'd like to thank all of our sponsors, but also Green Monster Roller Sports. Green Monster, their skates can beat up your skates. You can check out the Antic Boots and everything at Green Monster. Meanwhile, we are going to go, but before we do that, I don't know who that is. Is that Bork? Okay, yes. Handwriting is hard. Talking is hard, and we were happy to do it for you in this game. I'm AK-40 Ounce.
I'm Reverend Norman. You're watching the International 2014 Division I Playoffs from Evansville, Indiana, brought to you by Demolition City Roller Derby and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. This has been the Windy City Rollers taking on the Texas Roller Girls Texecutioners, and your final score, 176-173, darned if it's not.
That's right. We're going to send it down to Muckety Muck on the floor. He's got Bork, 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 and those are two fun names to say. Take it away.
Much an incredible victory here by the Windy City Rollers, 176-173. The captain, Bork, 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 joins us right now. Congratulations to the emotions you're feeling right now.
Thank you so much. It's overwhelming right now.
I was going to say, did you think Texas underestimated you coming into this contest?
You know, it's hard to say. We've been doing a lot of hard work this year. Maybe they did, maybe they didn't, but, you know, we just wanted to stick to our game the whole time, and we've had this phrase going all year, we could, we did, you know, putting it all out in the future. We've done it already. We're just here to get there, right where we've already planned to be and worked hard for this year.
I've noticed your team very focused yet relaxed this weekend. How does this team rank in all the historical league or all the historical teams that Windy City has had? You're going to a big championship bout tomorrow. How does this team rank to the teams in the past?
Sure. You know, I think that the goal and responsibility of every league and every team in it is to get better every year. I think this is the best team we've ever seen in the current version of the rule set. We have a lot of camaraderie going on. We have a lot of really good attitudes and a lot of hard work. We put in a lot of hard work right now. Every team's done that in the past, but we feel that we put in that little extra oomph to really take down the teams that are here this weekend.
Two more questions. The first one has to do with what's in your hand right there. I noticed a can of soup, but you got to elaborate on this one.
It's just a can of soup. It's a little inside joke we have.
Inside joke? Yeah. You got to open up. You just can't leave it open-ended like that.
We got it. Maybe in November if we get there.
Fair enough. First big task is tomorrow. What do you got to do against London?
Stay calm and stay focused. You know, I think that we've got some things we got to tighten up today. It was a very close game. Texas put up an awesome fight. we don't like to play it that close. So we got to clean up our gameplay, keep our penalties low, and correct the little mistakes that happened throughout the way.
Go enjoy the moment. I don't want you to miss out on this opportunity. We'll see you tomorrow in the gold medal bout.
Thank you so much.
All right, Bork, 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 with the big victory. It was Windy City, 176-173, to conclude what was a fun one here in Evansville, Indiana. Now that we've finished the coverage here on Saturday, let's tell you what's coming up for our final day of coverage here on WFTDA.TV. Five big bouts starting at 10 a.m. Central. We will see you in the ninth place bout. It's Ohio versus Houston at 12 noon for the seventh place Duke. It will be Steel City versus Toronto at 2 o'clock. We've got in the fifth place bout Nashville versus Arizona. In the third place bout, it's going to be Texas versus Jacksonville at 4 o'clock. And then for all the marbles in the championship bout, 6 p.m., we will see ourselves the top seed London and the upset-minded Windy City Rollers. We will see that one at 6 o'clock. And, of course, the winner of that one is the number one seed heading into the next round, going on over into Nashville. It's been a fun one here on WFTDA.TV. For all the fans here watching in Derby, you had to enjoy the action. Come and join us again tomorrow at 10 Eastern or 10 Central. For everybody here at WFTDA.TV, thanks so much for joining us. I'm Muckety Muck, and we'll see you tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. in Evansville.
This represents to me like 7 years of, like, you know, blood, sweat, and tears, and I'm really proud to be part of that team and to turn up as a team to a venue and have people intimidated at the thought of playing us. My name's Steph Maney. I skate for the London Roller Girls, and S1 is part of my uniform.
Pinkin and Trish the Dish here to tell you about Sin City Skates. Sin City Skates began in our living room in 2005 and has since grown into this 2,000 square foot warehouse and showroom where we stock everything for derby. If it's derby related, we probably have it. Need help? With a combined on-track derby experience of over 24 years and still playing, we test everything we sell and we know the difference between facts and our opinions. We're always happy to share both with you to help you make the right decisions. So call us, SinCitySkates.com.
You're watching WFTDA.TV.